Hayes Mine in Yancey County, North Carolina. Closest town, Burnsville. It's in the Pisgah National Forest, where they've granted us a rockhounding area to surface collect for some amazing aquamarine beryl. It takes a little work. You have to break the pegmatite rocks with a hammer, or you can surface collect the beryl form crystals. It's about a 25-minute hike up the trail. I would say medium grade. Once you cross a small creek, you continue on the trail till you come to another creek. That creek, you'll notice the white pegmatite rocks will be in there, unlike the first creek you see here that you cross. The white pegmatite will lead you up the hill on the bank of that creek. The tailings extend to the top of the mountain. You'll see other signs where people have been rockhounding by cracking rocks looking for these crystals. At this point, you just go wherever you want to go. From this being a previous mica mine, look at the soil, just glittered. This is a really neat piece of pegmatite. It shows the smoky vein going through the feldspar, which is white with, you got mica, garnet. The garnet's causing the little bit of brown staining. The geology up here is really neat. You can really learn a lot from these rocks. When I'm breaking for beryl, I'm not necessarily looking for something so tight formation crystal-wise. I'm looking for them to start getting larger. See if I can find a piece to show you real fast, which is always the challenge, but you can see how the mica books even get larger on this piece here. I wouldn't necessarily break that, not saying there's not a crystal in there, but larger the crystallized mica, the larger the crystal form of feldspar is, the better shot you have at breaking into a really nice piece of aquamarine or beryl, helidor. You never know. Once I start seeing the smoky mixed in with the tourmaline, such as this piece, it's a good chance there's beryl aquamarine or beryl in general with it associated. That would be a first choice on breaking up. Hammer. Safety glasses. Here's what we're searching for. A beautiful aquamarine beryl in the pegmatite with a little tourmaline crystal in the center. I chose to leave it in the matrix. Now when I'm breaking pegmatite, I like to leave them in the matrix. It just shows how the mineral formed. Surface collecting, like here, most of the time you find them free floating without the matrix. A lot of the rocks are loose and you can fall, so take your time. Now I really like this type of material to find things in. It's more of a yellow feldspar with that nice gray smoky. I think somebody else found the big chunk of that, and that's probably what's left of it. Here's another specimen that I cobbed out. It looks very similar to the pegmatite that I just showed you. The darker yellow and the smoky. See, and you do it slowly, because once it starts cracking, you can kind of be easy if you start seeing color. So once you find some color, you start working with your hammer from the outside of the rock in. Each mineral has a different hardness, so where they meet together, hitting with the hammer should separate them. It's not that easy though. That's the trick to getting a really beautiful specimen from Ray Mine. You take some practice, and it's always not your fault. Sometimes the mineral has a crack that you can't see, or it is your fault. Such as this specimen, I thought I had a chance. A few hits with a hammer, and I was devastated. Now this crystal was broken and rehealed itself. Nature and its wonders. Hexagons and pegmatite starts it all. Also, stay out of the barbed-wired areas. They are protecting the mine shafts and the adits that extend hundreds of feet vertically downward. You do not want to be anywhere near these. They're in horrible shape, but fortunately for us, they put the tailings on the whole mountainside for us to look through. Stay out, stay alive. See how tight all these little mica books are? That's the real silver shiny stuff. And the feldspar and the quartz, which is the white and the gray. Extremely small, smaller than my finger. You look at these rocks over here and you start seeing that feldspar is a lot larger. The mica books, a lot larger. Yes, it melted and got small over here, but you have a nice possibility in this section of a rock to find a crystal. So I'm nearing the top of the mountain. Its elevation's about 3,800 feet. Of course, it's starting to rain, so I'm going to start making my way downward. Normally, you have an amazing view, depending on the time of the year from here. Working our way to the creek. Looking back up at the right side. I just came down that. Tailings galore. Slow down, enjoy yourself while you're out here. While you stop hammering, it can be a pretty calm and tranquil place. Good to carry a bucket of water up here. It's hard to keep your balance in the first place, but don't try to fill the bucket to the top. Just do a quarter way full and take it up there, wash off some rocks, crack a few rocks, and who knows, you might go home with a really beautiful specimen. It's a challenge up here. But I found some beautiful stuff. So at this point in my trip, it started raining. From the creek at the bottom of the tailings, it's about a 20-minute hike to the car. So keep that in mind if you hear a thunderstorm. So my day got cut short a little bit. So as the rain picked up on my way out, look what I found under a little waterfall. So this is the summertime at Ray's Mine. In my opinion, it's one of the more challenging times to rockhound. The season change provides better views, which are just jaw-dropping at times. Also in the spring, you have the winters freeze and thaw, which pushes the crystals to the surface, allowing you to surface collect. I hope you all enjoyed the video. Like and subscribe, and thank you for watching.